Everyone, this is Ed Unik. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how to obtain the Norton's equivalent of a given circuit. First, what is Norton's theorem? Norton's theorem states that any two-terminal linear network, that is two terminals A and B, it's a linear network with voltage, current sources and resistances can be replaced by an equivalent circuit consisting of a current source in parallel with a resistance. So it is in many ways similar to Thevenin's theorem, but in many other ways it is the exact opposite. So let's understand Norton's theorem with a problem. So suppose we are asked to find the Norton's equivalent of such a circuit. Here we have to replace this whole system with a single current source that is having value IN, which is Norton's current, in parallel with the resistance RN or Norton resistance. So to find Norton's equivalent, the first thing we do is we just join these terminals, and the Norton current IN is simply the current passing through this branch. So we have to find this IN, which is the value of our final current source. So as there are two sources, I am using superposition theorem. You can also use other methods like mesh analysis or whatever. So superposition theorem, we first activate one source and find that current IN with respect to that source only. So first, on activating the 10 ampere current source and deactivating or short circuiting the 20 volts voltage source, I obtained a circuit like this, which I simplified. And here we can do another simplification. Here this current IN will only prefer the short circuit or zero resistance path. So this circuit is same as 10 ampere, 3 ohm. So this current IN is directly 10 amperes. So IN dash is 10 amperes. Now we have to consider the 20 volt source alone. On activating the 20 volt voltage source and deactivating or open circuiting the 10 ampere current source, I got a circuit like this, and I am applying mesh analysis. So writing the mesh equations, we get 3 into I1 minus I2 equal to 20 and 6 I2 plus 3 into I2 minus I1 equal to 0. These are our two mesh equations from which we have to obtain I2, that is IN. Simplifying these two equations, I got the simplified forms like this. And on substituting 2 and 1 and making 1 in terms of equation or I2, we get the value of I2 as 20 by 6, which can be approximated to 3.33 amperes. So as you can see, both these, this is IN double dash by the way, so both these currents are in the downward direction. So we, when algebraically summing the currents, we get the total Norton's current as IN equal to IN dash plus IN double dash, which gives 13.33 amperes. So we got the Norton current. Now we have to find out the Norton resistance. For this, we deactivate the two sources. On deactivating the two sources, we get a circuit somewhat like this, and we have to obtain the equivalent resistance seeing from this port A and B, these ports. So here also we can see that the current would prefer the short circuited path, so 3 ohm is not significant. So it can be replaced by a circuit like this, which equivalent resistance is directly 6 ohm. So the Norton's equivalent is our a current source in parallel with a resistance, and this resistance we got as 6 ohm, and the Norton current we got as 13.33 amperes. So this is our Norton's equivalent. So this is all we have to learn in Norton's equivalent. So practice with more problems. Now don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you.